Happy Thursday, everyone. Thanks for joining our webinar, Critical Metrics for Distribution Companies. My name is Johnny Girardi. I'm the founder and CEO of DataSelf. And before I jump into the presentation, I just want to give a quick overview of why this company was founded. So several years ago, I was invited to join the business intelligence and analytics industry. And in my early career, you know, I was an engineer, a software programmer. So for me, reporting was something natural, something easy. I was technical, very technical with computers. And eventually had an MBA. So I had a good blend of, you know, technical expertise with computers as well as business insights. So for me, reporting was not an issue, but then I quickly realized that typically business people, the ones needing reporting or needing data analysis, they're usually not IT savvy, and they have to rely on someone else to help them with reporting. And sometimes you have to get a, you know, an answer right now, some information right now in the middle of a call, in a meeting, in a coffee shop, in a bar, let's say, and then, you know, since you can't, you just have to make a decision based on your gut feeling. So I found that, you know, business intelligence and analytics was really critical technology for helping decision makers making more informed decisions. And I decided to focus on the mid-market, where there is the critical need to give management better information, but usually the tools out there are either too expensive or not sophisticated enough for them. So my vision starting the company was creating a solution designed for mid-market, very easy to use, and with a cost that they could afford. So that's where we are. This is the third generation of our solution. We have some major improvements in our latest, and that's what we're going to be talking about here today, is how critical metrics for distribution companies can help you make your process more efficient. So let's go through the process. I'll spend about 10 minutes talking about why analytics, specifically for distributors, looking from a key performance indicator standpoint. We'll spend about half an hour showing our metrics out of the box for distributors, as well as, you know, how easy it is to build and modify metrics on the fly. And then we'll open a Q&A session. So first of all, most of the time when we work with distribution companies, one of the most critical things for them is actually improve their processes, improve their sales, and improve their supply chain so they can sell more, they can sell better, they can be more profitable. So analytics plays a big role in helping sales and supply chain. Actually, we have helped distribution companies with, you know, all sort of different needs, you know, financial, like GL analysis, payables, payroll, and so forth. But traditionally, when they come to us, they're looking more for sales and supply chain. And this presentation today is going to focus on those two areas as a starting point. So let's talk about sales for distribution companies. What kind of, you know, challenges people have when they're trying to get a better understanding of their sales operations? Well, the most basic is just sales and profitability. To whom you're selling to, what product you're selling, which ones are growing the most, which ones are declining the most, how's the profitability, are clients really profitable, are products really profitable, are you pushing the right products, the right customers? Those questions sometimes is hard to answer. And with analytics, it's so much easier to find the right trends so you can push your business towards the most profitable or the ones that are more in line with your goals. So sales profitability analysis is one of the most basic needs that people ask for. Sometimes, you know, ordering and invoicing can have challenges. You know, it may take several days between an order getting in until you ship it. Sometimes there are inefficiencies in the way that you're shipping the products, maybe in the invoicing process, but analyzing it, knowing what's going on, and finding why things are not working as efficiently, that's something that analytics also can help you figure that out. Sales commission, you know, salespeople, they do well because they make money out of each sales. Many companies, they have complicated sales processes, sales commission processes, and they take a long time to calculate, sometimes only at the end of the month. With analytics, you know, we can have many metrics that usually you can keep track of commissions throughout the month. Any day you can see where salespeople are. Are they going the right direction? Are they going to meet their quotas, and make a dynamic and an incentive process for salespeople and management to keep track of that. So analytics plays a big role on that too. Forecasting, you know, just forecasting your sales is usually a big topic, being sure that you know what you're going to be selling and being able to source those things properly. So forecasting is a major area also of analytics. Pricing strategy, you know, maybe if you're selling your products to big boxes and when you go into contracts, they are like, you know, 6 months, 12 months, 2 year contract. So if you come with the wrong pricing, you may be hurting yourself. You may be not as profitable, or you may not be selling as much. So being able to analyze the pricing strategy across different products, different customers, different markets, verticals, and come up with the right price strategy is usually critical. And we have many metrics to help you with that. Finally, when you're analyzing your sales operation, sometimes you're just pulling from your accounting package sales information. Sometimes you have information coming from point of sale systems. Sometimes information coming from the your own clients' information, like, you know, the big boxes are sending you Excel files or Excel databases with their sales, and then you have to integrate that information with your own sales. So data integration is a big topic, and again, analytics can help you get a better insight of what's going on with your business. The next point is the analyzing supply chain. And inventory management is one of the most basic needs for better insights, looking at inventory turns, looking at how many days on average certain items are sitting on your warehouses, and being able to find ways to expedite that, or maybe know where to put your items in a way that they can more easily be shipped out of your warehouse, and which ones are shipping the most, so you got to put them in a place that is easier to pick them up and to ship. Analyzing inbound and outbound routing and logistics. You know, many people have products coming from overseas, from Asia, and, you know, it may take 60 days, 30 days to get here. So being able to be on top of the information to make better decisions is critical, and analytics help you with that. Collaborating with the whole supply chain, you know, from vendors to clients to shipping companies, analytics can contribute with that. Making a more efficient purchasing processes, you know, seeing lead times, who's falling behind, should you switch vendors, you know, is the pricing that you're purchasing the best one? So analytics can help you analyzing those things. Forecasting your inbound quantity on hands, looking at all the, you know, the inventory on hand today versus things that are supposed to arrive in the next, you know, few weeks or few months. And again, data integration. The ability to bring data from other data sources, such as from vendors, from shipping companies, and integrate with your ERP system can be challenging, and analytics can be a big role helping with that. So that's, you know, typically the challenges that people come to us looking for a better understanding of their processes. Let's see how we can help in the metrics we have out of the box for distribution companies. So why people come to DataSelf Analytics? In a single sentence would be empowering business users. Circling back to my initial vision of the company, business people, the decision makers, they need information to make more informed decisions. However, often they have to rely on an IT person to come up with new reports, slice and dice reports, and so forth. So DataSelf Analytics is a tool designed for business people. On average, more than 70% of the business person reporting needs, they can tackle the needs by themselves or with someone close to them, an assistant or a coworker. They don't need to call IT. They don't need to call a consultant. So empowering business users is really very important in this line of business. Second is, well, it must be super easy. You know, business people are super smart. They're running their operations. And when it comes to computers, sometimes they're not so familiar with computer technology. You know, they're used to browsers, emails, maybe Excel spreadsheets. And reporting and analysis could be too complicated. So being super easy, being available anytime, you know, they can be using a mobile device such as an iPad or a smartphone. They should be able to find information easily and quickly, and they should be able to slice and dice it as needed. So easy is one of the most critical benefits that this solution must have. Second is, over 13 years in this industry, we have built a very comprehensive out-of-the-box solution for distributors that today, if you get all the modules, you get more than 2,000 reports, dashboards, and KPIs ready to go. So it's easy to use, and it's a great starting point to analyze your business. When I go over the product presentation, I'm going to show some of these critical metrics available out of the box that may be important for your business. Alrighty, we call our solution like a Ferrari of data of analytics. So we're going to take it for a test drive right now, and we're going to cover three different buckets in my product presentation. First of all, secured access, how easy it is to access this information anywhere, anytime. Then I'm going to show some sample key performance indicators we have out of the box. And then finally, I'm going to show how easy it is to change things to slice and dice reports on the fly. So let's take this Ferrari for a spin. So I'm going to go first of all on what is the most popular way of consuming information out of a framework. And most people, when they are looking at their dashboards and their metrics, they go through a web portal. They can access the web portal information through web browsers or through mobile devices, again, such as tablets and smartphones. So typically, this web portal can be hosted on-premises in your network, or it can be in the cloud, your private cloud, or on our managed services. Regardless where it is, it's usually in some kind of, you know, very secured connection. Only people with the right information, with the right user credentials, will be able to access information, so very secure information. Now, when I log into this portal, and right now I'm logged as the administrator, then the second level of security kicks in. Only the dashboards that I'm allowed to see will be available for myself. So let's see, if I'm the salesperson, I would only be able to see the sales team dashboard. If I'm the finance department, I will only be able to see the finance dashboards. If I'm, let's say, the person who wants to have access to everything, like, you know, maybe a CEO wants to see everything, he could have access to everything. So security, based on your user credentials, can tell which dashboards you can look at. Now, when I come to my list of dashboards, and I'm just now going to go all the way to the bottom here, let's say I want to open one of these dashboards. Let's say I want to see my top customer by sales. So I click on the dashboard, and when that happens, the third layer of security kicks in. This dashboard is the same dashboard that all salespeople have access to. However, the system will only show me my own accounts. So if I'm the, you know, account manager for California, I only see my top customers in California, while, let's say, Mary, the account manager for Florida, she opens exactly the same dashboard, but she only sees her own accounts, while the VP of sales opens the same dashboard and see the top customers across all accounts. So three levels of security, information is highly secured, I only can see my own dashboards, and when I open a dashboard, I can be granular enough to only see my own information. So that's how security works. So let's talk about now some out-of-the-box reports and metrics available for distribution companies, and I'm going to show just a few to have an idea. This one is a good starting point. It's showing my top customer by sales this year to date. It's a fairly simple report, just my top customers. I have bars which are represented by, you know, on the sales scale here, and the profitability by the black dots. So I can see in the same screen, you know, how much sales and how profitable they are. I also have the color schema showing profitability from this red to green scale, so I could tell that, you know, my biggest client in sales is actually not so profitable, which is usually fairly common. But maybe, you know, this one here, you know, is not that big and is fairly unprofitable. Is there something wrong with that? You know, should we work better with this client to try to make more money out of it? It's a problem to maybe you guys to figure out and solve. So we have actually lots of reports showing top performers, you know, top by sales, by purchasing, by inventory, by financials, whatever. You can see, you know, top customers, top salespeople, top products, territories, top GL accounts by expenses, you name it. Now, something usually more intriguing than the top performers is what's changing the most in any given time. And let me show an example that we also have out of the box ready to go. This report here is showing my top customers by sales change since last year to date. And the axis here is, you know, sales change this year to date minus prior to date. So the ones with growing the most in sales since last year are these ones. And most likely, these guys are super happy. My salespeople are on top of them. And, you know, it's just happy story. It's a win-win. How about these customers here? These customers are declining the most in sales since last year to date. And again, this could be quarter to date, could be month to date, could be period, could be moving weeks. But the point is, why are these clients declining so much? Sometimes it's okay. Sometimes it's seasonal, no problem. But sometimes there are issues with some of these customers. They're not happy. Maybe the competitor is still in their way. And if you don't act proactively in a timely manner, you may lose them for good. So looking at the top growth and decline from any standpoint, you know, maybe on your expenses, maybe on your inventory on hand, can reveal critical metrics in your business. And out of the box, we have lots of those reports to help you focus your energy in what's important. Let me show another example on the sales side. Let's see here. My next example is this one here, regular customers with no sales. Sometimes you're trying to find things that are no longer happening. This is a very simple example. If you have, let's say, recurring customers that are always buying, why some of them are no longer buying the last 30 days, 60 days, 90 days? Sometimes it's okay, it's seasonal, but sometimes, again, there's some problem, and if you don't act proactively, it may be too late to reverse the trend. So this is like a simple dashboard that shows on the left my list of customers that were buying the last 60 days, but not in the last 30 days. So very insightful information that can help you focus your resources on where you may get the biggest bang for the buck. And we have, you know, as I mentioned, more than 2,000 reports and KPIs out of the box. We have for purchasing, some examples here, like, you know, to analyze lead times. We have pricing strategy analysis, cost of sales, inventory productivity. There's a lot of different reports, but my goal today was just to give a glimpse into the value of these out-of-the-box dashboards. And then, you know, if you have more interest, you can contact us so we can talk in more details about other possibilities. Now, one of the most important things in the long run is, even though this solution comes with lots of reports and key performance indicators out of the box, it's how easily you can customize your own, how easily you can change them on the fly. So in the long run, maybe in the short term, being able to easily change things, easily slice and dice, is critical. So let me show how does that work. I'm going to show now how easy it is to build a new dashboard from scratch. And I don't want to mean that, you know, everyone is going to do this. What I want to show is, if you want to learn how to do it, you can. This technology has been designed with business people in mind, so it's very easy to use. There are some business people that are too busy, they're not going to do it, but hopefully they usually have an assistant or someone close to them, like a peer, that will be able to offload those requests. So let me show how it works. This tool here is the desktop tool that allows extensive capabilities when it comes to ad hoc analysis. And this tool has on the left side what is called a data panel. And right now I'm looking at sales analysis information. As you can tell, I see here business-friendly information. Like, you know, I have a customer with a customer list of customer reporting parameters. I go to product, I see product-related information. I go to the invoice, I see invoice-related information. So it's very easy for a business person to find, okay, find out what they're looking for. Also, I have the bottom measures that I want to keep track. You know, I want to see sales, cost of sales, gross profit, quantity returned. If I'm looking at a inventory, I want to see quantity on hand, amount on hand, things of that nature. Now, keep in mind, again, business people, they need things that are easy to use. So we need, like, you know, we need some kind of, you know, on-demand help. So let's say if I come here and I put the mouse over the salesperson reporting parameter, the tool tells me that this salesperson is actually the rep recorded on the invoice. You know, when the invoice was issued, got a salesperson code. That's the one we're using for this report. While if I go to my customer and I use the account manager, the tool is telling me right now in this pop-up window that this is the rep currently assigned to the customer. So depending how I want to do my analysis, I want to use one or the other. And the good news is the tool gives you these pop-up windows that help business people to know what they're looking at. The second very exciting information about this technology is that the engine behind it was designed by Stanford University professors. These professors, they studied how business people look at different types of data and get insights from the business data. So they look at data visualization techniques, and they come up with an engine that powers the solution. And what this technology does at the end of the day is it helps decision makers to get insights. You know, building reports and dashboards is a discovery process. It's a journey. The business person has an idea where they want to go to, but until they see something, they don't know exactly. And that's why often when a business person asks an IT person, a consultant, for a report, it takes several interactions. You know, the person comes with a report, the business person looks, oh yeah, cool, great, but can you please change this? Can you filter by that way? Come back, oh, but can you do this? Can you change the color? Can you? So it's a discovery process. This tool does a great job helping decision makers walk through the journey with no assistance or with little assistance. So let's take a look how that works. So I'm going to make an example. You know, suppose that my VP of sales, she is in California, you know, in a meeting with the sales team. She calls me and says, hey, Johnny, I need a new dashboard that shows me sales and profitability by salesperson. And I also want to see how sales is going from a geography standpoint. You know, please. And by the way, on the geography analysis, I want to see how well I'm doing with my deal sizes. Am I selling bigger deals or smaller deals? How is it going? So she calls me. She leaves this message like, you know, in 30 seconds, and I know how she operates. And she's meeting with the guys with an iPad on her hand. I'm going to be efficient and give her what she's looking for. So let's do that. Let's build an example of this dashboard. So she wants to see sales, gross profit by salesperson. So I just select those three reporting parameters. How do I want to see this? Well, this button here that expands the Show Me panel, it has that technology about helping decision makers walk through the journey. So as you can tell, I have a bunch of data visualization options that are highlighted that are related to the components that I selected here. And I don't have geography highlighted because I don't have a geography like, you know, customer address or ship to, so I cannot put on the map right now. So the tool knows what I selected and gives me the options that make sense. So right now, I just have to pick and choose. Just very easily click one option at a time, let's say. The first one is just the grid approach. You know, if you want to see numbers by the penny, that's the way to go. And sometimes that's what people want. I know that my boss, she likes charts, so I'm going to use another approach. Let's click the next one. This one here is kind of cool. It shows me bigger boxes for bigger sales, and the color of the boxes represented by profitability. Kind of cool, but I think she's not going to like it, so let me try the next one. So the point is, you keep on clicking on these options here until you find something that you feel, wow, this is the way to go. In my example, this is the way to go. I have a list of salespeople on the left. I have bars for the amount of sales, and I have bars for the gross percentage gross profit. So I like this approach. Now I know that, you know, my boss, she usually don't manage these two guys because they're like rock stars. They sell a lot. She usually asks me to exclude them, so I'm going to exclude them out of my query very easily, very quickly, point and click. Okay, I remove those two guys, and now I'm going to sort this and put my top at the top because I always know she's interested in the top performers. So this insight is becoming very informative, very educational. Now, I also know she's very visual. She likes colors. She's a woman, right? So I actually like colors too. I'm not a woman. Anyway, so let's put the color in the gross profit in my color marks. And what I do now is I have a beautiful insight where I can see the sales and profitability in colors. And just by looking at this, I could tell my top salespeople by sales is not very profitable, and this one here is really needing some help. So I think she's going to love this query. I love it. Let me wrap it. So I'm going to call sales by rep. That's the first query, pretty straightforward. You know, it doesn't take much time to learn it and to build it. Now the second query is the most exciting one from my perspective. She wants to see sales on a geography component, looking at, you know, large sales deals, how they're doing. So let's choose customer address and sales. So I just pick those two. And again, I go to the Show Me button where I have my journey helper. And now I can tell I have mapping capabilities. So let's put on the map this information. And right now, I have, you know, in my customer address, I have a country, state, city, and zip structure. I can have any kind of, you know, geography structure. I can have a county, territories, actual address, anything. And I can drill from all of these buckets. So right now, I'm on the country level. I'm going to expand this to go to the state level. So now I'm seeing by state sales and bigger bubbles showing bigger sales. Now let me make these bubbles a little bigger. So let me click on size and make a little bigger. Very straightforward, just like, and that looks the right size. Okay, now she said that she wants to see if their large deals are growing over, you know, over time. So let's bring large deal to this framework. In my invoice header, I have this deal size reporting parameter, which breaks down my invoice by small, medium, and large. And in my sample database, you can see here, the way we're breaking down is small is smaller than $1,000 and large is larger than $5,000, but this is configurable to any sizes. So I'm going to take the deal size and drop into my color mark and tell that I want to see this as a pie chart. Just point and click, and you got this beautiful map here where I can tell, you know, bigger bubbles, bigger sales, and then the bubbles are sliced by colors, which tell me the amount of sales for each type of, you know, deal size. I think she'll love this. Now she told me that when she wants to see if it's growing or declining. So I'm gonna, you know, add a time dimension to this analysis. And document date is my invoice date. I can also drag and drop things into my dashboard, such as, you know, putting my columns, for instance. So now I have per year a map, and I can see the trend. Now I think she's gonna be super happy with her West Coast team because California is definitely growing sales. And as you can tell, the blue, you know, slice is much bigger. So she's going to be tapping her back and her team's back. That's awesome news. Now, remember, you know, she's in a meeting with an iPad. And if I put this dashboard in an iPad, it's probably going to be too cluttered. So I don't think she's going to be happy yet. Let's spin it differently and see if we can get something better. Let's drop the dates to my rows instead. So now I have maps on a row schedule, kind of, you know, cool, but again, it's too cluttered for an iPad. Let me take the year and put in my pages approach. So now I have a single map, and I can put some notes here, such as tell the page name, which in this case is the period. So right there, we put the period name. So what I have now is a bigger map, and then I have the slider. If I change the slider, I change the period, and I see what's happening with my sales. And if I'm in the presentation, I could put this on a loop playback and press play. And now as the year changes, I see the trend changing. I think she will love this. I think I'm going to get a raise today. So this is my Ferrari, you know. Let me rename this query. It's going to be sales by state. Now I need to put this in a single dashboard, both queries, and publish to the server so she can access it. So I'm going to click on this button, which creates a new dashboard. And here on the left, I have the existing queries. I could have several queries, and I could just drag and drop. Very straightforward. So I only have two. Let's use those two. Drag and drop my sales by state in my query area, and I'll tell to automatically fit my screen. And then I want to take the other query and drag and drop. Just drag, can be on the left, top, right, bottom, any quadrant. Just drag and drop. Very straightforward, very easy to use. Then I want to get more room for my query. And finally, I want to tell that each one of these quadrants are filters. So as she starts to slice and dice, she can control the whole dashboard individually. And that's it. I mean, you know, if I were not talking and explaining, I would have built this probably in half of the time. But it was easy. It was very straightforward. I'm going to call this Johnny dashboard. And then I'm going to publish the server. So I'm going to publish my workbook to the server. And then I'm going to say I want to save it to my sales. We'll put my sales team, for instance. I'm going to call this, Johnny DB. And here is where I control a level of security. I could tell what what team of people would be able to access the information. I could select, you know, the C-level management team, sales team, supply chain, and so forth. So for now, I'm going to leave as is. And I'm only going to publish Johnny Dashboard. So I'm going to publish it. And what the tool is doing now is sending this information to the server. And the server could be, let's say, in the cloud or in the private cloud. And I would call my boss, say, hey, boss, just refresh your dashboard and check for Johnny's dashboard. She would take her iPad or whatever she is. She would refresh her dashboard. And there it is. Very easily, very quickly, she finds a new dashboard. She clicks on it, and right there, she gets exactly the same information as I had on my computer. Now she calls me back and says, Johnny, great job, appreciate it. She comes here, and because she's the big boss, she has access to the whole dashboard, all information. But remember, she's just meeting the West Coast team, so she can use her fingers on the iPad and select only those three states, which is the West Coast. And when she does that, she changes the list of my whole dashboard, in this case, the list of salespeople selling to those three states. And even the legend has changed. Now, you know, suppose she's meeting with these people and she wants to talk with the ones that are not so profitable. So she can pick those guys, you know, Sam is one of them. And she can also click, you know, Derek, Abby, and so forth. And as she clicks, she gets automatically the whole dashboard to change to reflect what she's doing. Very easy, very straightforward. You know, we just showed an example how we can get a business person quick access to information that she didn't have before. Now, even better news is my boss, actually, she's fairly sophisticated. And she spent, you know, a couple of hours learning this tool. And now she's in the meeting, and she actually wants to see what products were sold by these salespeople. Or maybe what customers, what's going on with this profitability? She wants more analysis. Now she doesn't need to call me back anymore. Now she comes here on the iPad. She clicks on the edit button. And then she gets on the iPad a similar interface that I had on my desktop. And she can come here and start to change the query completely. So let's say she wants to see numbers now. So she clicks the number view. And let's say she wants to see sales by salesperson by customer. She comes to the list of, you know, requiring parameters. She grabs customer name and she drags it into the rows. And right there she sees by salesperson, by product, and see what's going on. Maybe she wants to add also the product line for this report. She goes with her fingers on the iPad. She goes to product and add product line description. Very easy, very straightforward. Now by salesperson, by customer, by product, sales and profitability. This is empowering business people with easy access information. Maybe she wants to, you know, to get this data here and actually download to an Excel or to some other data. She can click view data, and now when she do that, actually she's looking at all the underlying data that came up with that information. You know, invoice date, invoice number, salesperson, customer, product, everything, and she can download the information in Excel and make further analysis, for instance. The point is easy, the point is anywhere, anytime. Business people have a good grasp on their information and can make more informed decisions. That's pretty much the product presentation. Now I'm going to go back and wrap up with a few more PowerPoint slides. And I think I closed my PowerPoint, so let me reopen it. Sorry about that. So how we make the solution so easy and so fast? Well, we pull data from several ERP and CRM systems, like now from Sage products, from Microsoft products, Everest products, Sage and ERP products. We pull that information to a ultralight data warehouse, which is usually on-premises, meaning it's installed on your network, wherever it is. Then we push information to our DataSelf analytics platform, which is powered by Tableau. And this can be on-premises or in the cloud. It can be private cloud or our own managed services cloud. But at the end of the day, the good news is business people will have easy access to information anytime, anywhere. From an IT standpoint, this framework here is fairly easy to maintain. So the idea is whoever's going to be maintaining this from an IT standpoint, they'll be able to provide a much better reporting capabilities with much less time to fulfill their client needs more quickly and more efficiently than if you don't have a solution like ours. What about ROI? Well, when you look at analytics in business intelligence, this tool actually has been designed to support the decision-making process, has been designed to support business people who are making decisions every day, every time, any minute. And if they have better information, hopefully they can make better decisions and hopefully move the needle. And if you have a sharp, business people, definitely if they have better decisions, more informed decisions, they're going to make better decisions, and that will move the needle. If you're, let's say, selling 10 million a year, 15 million a year, and if you improve your bottom line by 1%, how much money is that? Typically, our solution, we help our clients improve the bottom line from 1 to 5%. So that's how you look at the return on investment. We have several clients that actually, in a few days, they paid for the investment in DataSelf analytics because out of the 2,000 reports and KPIs, they found ones that unveiled critical metrics that were having big losses or missing big opportunities. So right off the bat, it paid itself as a solution. Having said that, typically you can have DataSelf analytics using a 4 to 5 figure investment. We have monthly subscription as well as yearly subscription. So it's not expensive to get this high-end technology for your management team. That's pretty much my one-way talk. I would like to now open for, first of all, thank you for sticking around and hearing our presentation. Let's open a Q&A. So if you have questions, please feel free to type into the GoToMeeting panel and I'll answer them. Let me check if we have anything here right now for questions. So, yep, we have some questions here. So the first question is how long it takes to deploy DataSelf analytics. When it comes to work per se, it can vary, from a few hours to very simple deployments up to days to weeks worth of work. Most of the time, in a couple of days worth of work, we get a system up and running. And this is usually spread out in a few weeks. So usually if you contract us today, most likely in 2 to 3 weeks, you have your management team using the solution. So it's fairly easy, fairly fast to get it up and running. Other questions? Let me check here. How about training? Good question. So as I mentioned, this solution is being really designed to support business people. We actually have many users that learn how to use a solution just by poking around, right-click, left-click, and giving it a try. Anyway, on average, it takes a few hours of training to become self-sufficient with the tool. We have web-based live training to get started. And also we have online self-serve videos that you can watch at your own pace. And we're here to help you maximize your learning. So if you want, you know, live web-based classes, or if you want to go the other way, we'll help you with your own needs to be sure that your team will be comfortable using the solution. But overall, it's a matter of hours to learn how to become self-sufficient. And again, typically, you can have your business people doing things that today you usually need a consultant or an IT to support. Very good question. Another question here. Cost per module, I guess. So there are a few different pricing components. One of it is users. The more users, the more likely you're going to be paying more. There are four different types of, you know, user licenses. The most expensive one is a few hundred dollars per year per user, and the least expensive costs nothing for extra users. You just buy a module that distributes static dashboards for unlimited number of users. So user pricing can vary from zero per additional user to a few hundred per year. Now also we have pricing by module. As I mentioned, we have, you know, if you look at an ERP solution, we have a sales module, we have a purchasing module, inventory module, financials module. Each module has an analytics from that standpoint. And depending what accounting package you have or what CRM you have and what modules you want, the price changes. But overall, to give you some ideas, usually every module will cost a few thousand dollars per year, depending on the package. So let's say if you get an entry-level cost of, let's say, $10,000 per year, and then you want to add, let's say, an additional module of inventory analysis, is going to cost you $12,000. So it's incremental. Very good question. Other questions? Let's see here. There's another question here. Can this application import data from other data sources? Very good question. Let me see if I go back here and show you the architecture. So out of the box, as I mentioned, we have a pretty comprehensive package pulling from several ERPs and CRMs for a website. Let me see here if I can show you quickly our website to give you a quick insight into what we have available. So these are the products that right now we have available out of the box, a very comprehensive solution. So if you have these packages, it's almost like plug and play, and you have plenty of value. Now, if you have other data sources, such as, you know, you may have a POS system, you may have a Excel spreadsheets, access information that you want to bring it in, yes, we can pull data from any data source, combine that data along with your, you know, ERP package or CRM, combine them. That's a technical job, but once the technical job has been completed and we push to the analytics component, now business people can easily see that. Just to give an example, if you look at sales analysis, and let's say that you have a proprietary CRM system using Excel or whatever it is, we can actually take that information from the CRM system and combine with your sales information coming from your ERP package. And now when I'm going to do my sales analysis, I can actually see sales from the ERP, sales transactions, as well as from categorizations coming from the CRM package, for instance. So yes, we can bring data from any data source. Very good question. Other questions? There's another question here. So I already mentioned about the pricing per user, so I guess we don't need to answer that one. What is the how we compare the solution against Sage Intelligence Reporting and Sage Intelligence Enterprise? So Sage Intelligence, it's the latest technology they have added for analytics from their own platform. It's you know, the way we put things is we're like a Ferrari, you know, easier to use, faster to run, but sophisticated. You can have web, mobile, export to Excel, very comprehensive, very focused on business users. So it's like a Ferrari. When they look like Sage Intelligence, reporting enterprise, they're great solutions, great pricing, but it's like, you know, the Beamers, the Mercedes, the Porsches. If you have a small budget and you just need something, you know, better, not the greatest, they may be a good offer. You know, definitely a great offer with a very affordable pricing. We really focus on user friendliness, anywhere, anytime. That's where we shine. You know, if you are a business person, busy, don't have time to learn technology, but you want to be able to get some information out of it without calling other people, that's where we focus. Best of the breed technology, super easy to use. Good questions. Other questions? There's another question here. It's a little bit more technical. Is it possible to make sub-reports like in Crystal? That's a very technical question. But the answer is yes. Let me just go back here to the dashboards and make a parallel. Actually, let me go to the desktop client instead. If you look at this dashboard that I created here, I have two complete different segments of data coming from sales. And I can actually have several. I can have, you know, 4, 5, 10 different segments, all interrelated. And as I take one of these segments and I filter it, all the other segments, like sub-reports, they'll be reflecting changes. So I can have, like, you know, big view, drill down into something, drill across with something else. It's very sophisticated. Crystal sub-reports is a very technical topic, so if you want to discuss more detail, I'll be glad to even bring one of our consultants so we can tell how much easier you can actually take care of, you know, crystal reports, sub-reports using dashboard capabilities instead. Any other questions? Looks like we're running out of questions. Anyway, if you have more questions, let me open here my slide. Oops, did I close it again? Yep, so let me put the last slide with my contact information. If you have more questions, if you want to contact us to discuss anything about metrics for distribution companies or analytics for distribution companies or how we operate, how our analytics solution works, give us a call. You know, you can see my cell phone on the screen. You can email, you can use Twitter or, you know, whatever's more convenient for you. We're here to help. And we're excited to educate you with some information. And if you will do business, it will be great. If we're just education, we are happy as well. Thank you very much for joining us. Have a happy Thursday. And looking forward to hopefully contact you in the near future again. Thank you.